table over there, and here next to you, we have a collection of books that we read from. Like, they're slightly different. I mean, inside, they all say the same thing, but to make it easier for us to all follow along, we're all using the same book. Okay.
And if you go on the other side from the back, it's in English. And the other side, it's in English, yes.
Okay, so we're going to use the English side. And,
okay, we'll go.
We start
with the Seder table.
Page one.
It doesn't say one.
Yeah, on the next page it says
one. Ah, why? Why not this one?
Because that's an introduction.
Ah, okay.
Oh, let me just explain one thing.
Yes.
It says leader, participant, and when it says participant, we take turns reading. Do you want to do any of the reading in English? Or do you prefer just for us to do it?
It's up to you.
It says participant, and then
saying,
it says leader.
You want to read.
The leader, I read, and the participant.
Every time you'll be the participant.
Okay. It's so I'm going to be the leader and I'll be the participant, but
yeah,
we switch between us.
Sometimes
I'm the leader and he's the participant. But we'll.
Okay. We are about to begin the recitations of ancient story of Israel redemption from bondage in Egypt. The purpose of the Seder is to afford us the opportunity to recall the dramatic and miraculous events which led to the exodus from an ancient land of slavery. The Bible, centuries ago, instructed us to meet as we do tonight when it declared, "And thou shalt tell thy son that day, saying, It is because of that which the Lord did for me when I came forth out of Egypt." By this, the Bible means that young and old should gather on the eve of Passover in order to we might relate to the children and to all the thrilling chapter in the history of our people.
Okay, want me to read some reading?
Leader two, yeah. We have before us the Seder plate, which is this. On it have been placed the main symbols of this service. Participant.
Okay, first we have three matzahs.
In here.
They're in here. Those are the matzot. Commemorating the bread which our forefathers were compelled to eat during their hasty departure from Egypt. We use three matzahs to represent the three religious groupings of the Jewish people, Kohen, Levi, and Israel. They are placed together to indicate the unity of the Jewish people. In unity, we find our strength and power to survive. The second symbol is the rope. Well, I'll be the participant. You're the leader, I'm the participant.
I can go to sleep then.
The second symbol is the roasted shank bone, which reminds us of the Paschal lamb, a special animal sacrifice which our ancestors offered on the altar of the Great Temple in Jerusalem on the Passover holiday. The third symbol is a roasted egg, which reminds us of a second offering brought to the temple on Passover. It was known as the festival offering, for it was brought on each of the three festivals, Pesach, Shavuot, and Sukkot. The fourth symbol is the maror, the bitter herbs, which reminds us of the bitterness of slavery, which our ancestors were compelled to endure. The fifth symbol is the charoset, made to resemble mortar, used at this time to remind us of the mortar with which our forefathers made bricks for the building of Egyptian cities. The final symbol is the karpas, a green vegetable used to remind us that Pesach coincides with the arrival of spring and the gathering of the spring harvest. Passover in ancient times was also an agricultural festival, and an occasion on which our ancestors gave thanks for the earth's rich bounties. Four times in the course of this service, we shall partake of the wine, symbol of joy and thanksgiving. The four cups represent the fourfold promise which the Lord made to the Israelites in Egypt. In the following words, he assured them that they would be freed from servitude. I will bring you forth, I will deliver you, I will redeem you, I will take you.
There are the symbols of Passover, echoes of the past and reminders of the present. As we partake of them, may we remember the events which they recall, and may we embody the spirit of our present day endeavors, and we shall now sanctify the holiday with the recitation of the Kiddush. Let us rise.
Okay, so we have to go.
Why? Just a little bit, that's right.
Well, you're supposed to drink the whole cup, but
yeah, well, I'm not in a situation yet that I want to drink the whole cup. Okay.
Okay, so, honey?
So, yeah, I read not the Friday, I read what's underneath it.
You start in...
Now that it's Shabbat, it's a problem.
Okay, no, you start here.
Yeah, in
the middle. And then you continue with the paragraph at the bottom.
Okay. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri hagafen.
Amen.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam. Asher bachar banu michol am veromemanu michol lashon vekidshanu vemitzvotav. ותיתן לנו אדוני אלוהינו באהבה את מועדי השמחה, חגים וזמנים לששון, את יום חג המצות הזה. זמן חירותנו, מקרי קודש, זכר ליציאת מצרים, כי בנו בחרת ואותנו קידשת מכל עמים. מועדי קדשך, בשמחה ובששון הנחלתנו. ברוך אתה אדוני, מקדש ישראל והזמנים.
ברוך.
את ברוך אתה אדוני, אלוהינו מלך העולם, בורא מאור האש. ברוך אתה אדוני, אלוהינו מלך העולם, שמבדיל בין קודש וחול, בין אור לחושך, בין ישראל לעמים, בין יום השביעי לששת הימים המעשה, בין קודשת שבת לקודשת יום טוב והבדלה. הבדלת, I don't see the T, at the top end, okay. ואת יום השביעי מששת ימי המעשה קידשת. הבדלת וקידשת את שמך ישראל, את עמך ישראל, וקדשך ברוך אתה אדוני, מבדיל בין קודש לקודש.
ברוך אתה אדוני מלך העולם שהחיינו וקיימנו והגיענו לזמן הזה.
אמן. We drink wine.
That last prayer is thanking God that we all stayed alive and made it to this day.
Okay.
Especially after a year of Corona. I said especially
the face that Jacqueline makes after the
sure
wine.
Especially after a year of Corona, it's very meaningful.
Yeah.
That we all made it to
we made
this
it
year.
To, yeah. Okay. Now
okay, now we turn the page.
Yeah,
page
Friday.
Five.
That's Friday. That doesn't go on.
Okay, now.
We start with Urjas. We start with Urjas.
Okay, so we do. Urjas, okay, the second.
What? I can't read it.
Okay.
The second ceremony of the Seder is known as Urjas, washing of the hands. This is a symbolic act of purification, which precedes our participation in the religious service. Two children bring a pitcher of water, a bowl, and a towel. They offer these to all assembled, who pour water over their hands into the bowl.
Okay, you know what, Jacqueline? I'm going to ask you to help us with this because you're the youngest one here. Mm-hmm. Okay, you see that there's
water.
A bowl.
Yeah.
So now you go to each one of us and bring the towel, and we're going to wash it in the hand, and then I'll do it for you.
Okay.
Why don't you start with me?
No, I will bring this.
Yeah, and the towel. Michael can go first.
Okay.
What about my mom?
Well, she'll see. No, we'll go this way.
Okay.
I'll start.
I will go that way. So I will give you.
Okay. So then now the first time, here, I can take it. Now the first time, we don't say the blessing. Mm-hmm. We just pour a little water over our hands, 2-3 times each hand. Okay, now.
Have a hold.
Yeah, and I'll pass this over.
Now we go in.
Okay.
And then the hand.
I will pour.
Little here. Okay, thank you.
And your mommy?
Yeah. Mommy, the same.
Put your hands inside, one this hand, and a little bit this hand, and again. There and there. Okay. Here, mommy. Yeah, and now I'll do it for you. Okay, without your finger, though. Without getting your finger wet.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, you can dry yourself up. Here. Okay, we did that.
And we're going to use it again.
In the kitchen.
No, leave it there.
Ah, okay.
We'll use it again.
Okay.
Purpose.
Yeah. Distribute green pieces of green vegetables, such as parsley, lettuce, or watercress, that all assemble and say. The third ceremony is partaking of the karpas. We now dip.
We have to take it.
Yeah, okay.
Does anybody take a piece of lettuce or a piece of parsley?
Here, mommy. Okay.
Okay, now this has salty water in it. And we dip it into the salt water. And in partaking of this fruit of the earth, we give thanks to God for all his bounties. We also recall that our forefathers were tillers of the soil, who were ever grateful for the earth's produce. And tasting of the salt water, we are asked to remember the tears which our ancestors shed while suffering the tortures of slavery. May our gratitude for the blessings which we enjoy help to soften the pain of sorrow and convert tears to joy and appreciation. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei pri ha'adama.
Just take the stick out. Okay, that's good. That's enough. The sticks we don't need. Where do we put this?
Just on the plate.
Huh? Yeah, put it on the plate.
Yeah, hats.
What is now?
The three matzot.
One second, honey. I have to put the potatoes in the oven.
Okay.
you keep on eating.
Turn the oven off and just put the potatoes in.
Is it salty, mommy?
Yeah, that is salty, a little bit salty.
It's heavy.
Good. Huh, mommy? Taste all the peppers in the salt water. This is salt water, just leave it. We're going to put more things in the salt water.
Yeah?
Yes, mommy. Okay? Yafats. Places before him the three wrapped matzahs from the Seder plate. They're here. And now, I now perform the ceremony of Yahatz. I shall break the middle matzah. That's the number one. That's number two. Okay.
Setting it aside for the afikoman.
Yeah. And I'm setting it and putting it in here. Okay. And I'm putting it aside for now. Okay.
Oh. See, afterwards he hides it and we have to find it, so I'm keeping my eye.
I shall break the middle matzah and two removing one half and setting it aside. This will become the afikoman, the dessert to be eaten at the conclusion of our meal. Breaks.
Okay, you did it. You don't have to remove it.
Magid. Lachma.
The matzah.
Lachma ani adi, di achalu v'avata, avtana ba'ara'a di mitzrayim. Kol divchim yetei ve'achol, kol ditzrich yetei ve'ifsach. Asata aba leshana aba ba'ara'a di Israel. Asata avdei leshana aba b'nei chorim.
Lo, this is the bread of affliction, the humble and simple bread which our ancestors ate in the land of Egypt. Let anyone who is hungry join us at the Seder and let them partake of what we have to share. With gratitude for the blessings which we have been given, we invite the less fortunate to share with us at this meal and also at other times.
May the Jewish people, wherever they are, those of them still deprived of total freedom enjoy that liberty at this time next year.
May our brethren in Israel speedily attain freedom from fear and want and be privileged to build the symbol of peace for all the nations. Okay, we have sort of a surprise here because now we get to something that's called the four questions. Now the whole, at the beginning of the Seder, we said that the commandment is that you should tell your children the story. And so what you do is the child asks questions and then the rest of the Seder is actually you're answering the questions. Now I could do it, but I asked my daughter to record our grandchildren doing it. So I'm gonna, where did I put my phone?
Doesn't make any
sense. Oh, you have yours?
I have mine.
Okay. So we have our grandchildren singing the questions. So
you and Daniel, the children from
Debbie,
are going to sing us the four questions. The four questions of Pesach. One second. Okay. Here we go.
Do you hear that?
Shavuot.
You hear that, mommy?
What?
You hear?
Could you hear them?
Could you hear them?
Yeah, true.
Yeah. Or,
what is Alayla then?
This night.
This Alayla says
so
this night.
So now we have the translation here. Why is this night of Passover different from all other nights of the year? On all other nights, we eat either chametz or matzah, but on this night, we eat only matzah. On all other nights, we eat all kinds of herbs, but on this night, we eat only maror, that's the bitter herbs. On all other nights, we do not dip even once, but on this night, we dip twice into the salted water. On all other nights, we eat either sitting or reclining, but on this night, we eat reclining.
We shall now answer the four basic questions concerning Passover, which you have asked. Okay.
Once we were slaves to Pharaoh in Egypt, and the Lord in his goodness and mercy brought us forth from that land with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm.
Had he not rescued us from the hand of the despot, surely we and our children would still be enslaved, deprived of liberty and human dignity.
We therefore gather year after year to retell this ancient story. For in reality, it is not ancient, but eternal in its message and its spirit. It proclaims man's burning desire to preserve liberty and justice for all.
The first question asked concerns the use of matzah. We eat these unleavened cakes to remember that our ancestors and their haste of to leave Egypt could not wait for bread to rise, and so remove them from the ovens while still flat.
We partake of the maror, the bitter herbs, on this night, that we might taste of some bitterness, to remind ourselves how bitter is the lot of one caught in the grip of slavery.
We dip twice in the course of the service greens in salt water, and maror, and in charose, once to place tears,
replace
tears with gratefulness, and once to sweeten bitterness and suffering.
The fourth question asks, why on this night we eat in a reclining position? To recline at meal times in ancient days was the sign of a free man. On this night of Passover, we demonstrate our sense of complete freedom by reclining during our repast. The four sons.
Of four sons that Torah speaks, describes thereby four types of Jews.
The wise son, the wicked son, the simple one, and the young one who does not know enough to inquire.
The wise son asks, what mean these customs in which we engage, which the Lord commanded to observe?
He is regarded as wise, since he includes himself among those obligated to observe the traditions of Passover.
The wicked son asks, what mean these customs in which you engage, which the Lord commanded you to observe?
He is regarded as wicked, since he excludes himself from the obligated group assuming the Jewish duties are meant for others, not for him.
The simple one which complete unconcern regarding simple because of his difference, ask what is all this?
To him you shall respond, know well that the Lord did marvelous things for us by redeeming us with a mighty hand. It is therefore incumbent upon us to remember and to observe.
The young one, not yet able to inquire, is to be told the story of Passover in accordance with the biblical command.
And thou shalt tell thy son in that day, saying, it is because of that which the Lord did for me when I came forth out of Egypt.
It is incumbent upon us to emulate the wise son by remembering our duties to our people and our faith. We must share and the obligations to advance Torah and the Jewish way of life, to remove ourselves from those endeavors, looking to others to carry the burdens. It is to fail in our responsibility. The wise son, the wise Jew, is he. He understands the importance of his personal participation and all efforts for the benefit of our people and the betterment of mankind.
Baruch Shomer Hatachato LeYisrael. Baruch Hu Shakadosh Baruch Hu Chishev Et HaKetz LaSot Kamash Amar LeAbraham Avinu VeBrit Ben Abatarim שנאמר, ויאמר לאברהם, ידע תדע, כי גר יהיה זרעך בארץ לא להם, ועבדים ועינו אותם 400 שנה. וגם את הגוי אשר יעבדו, דן אנוכי ואחרי כן יצאו ברכוש גדול.
Blessed is God who fulfills his promises, who is ever faithful to his servants who trust in him.
The Lord foretold the events of Israel's bondage when relating to Abraham, the future of his children.
Then did he describe the years of their service in foreign soil, tormented by a strange and hostile people.
'Twas then that he did also promise to rescue and redeem them, injustice, bringing judgment upon the cruel oppressor.
Great has been the Lord's divine promise, fulfilled and realized in days of yore.
Great have been his promises in all ages, source of hope to a stricken and downtrodden people.
Okay, now we lift drink. Our wine glasses.
Only lift them, you don't drink now.
You don't drink, you just lift it up.
In every
age, oppressors rose against us to crush our spirit and bring us low.
From the hands of all these tyrants and conquerors, the Lord did rescue and restore his people.
Not in Egypt alone did Israel face the threat of total annihilation.
In many lands and many ages, the flame of Jewish life faced the fierce winds of tyranny.
In all these battles and desperate struggles, God help and guidance assured our survival.
Our hope is strong and our faith unshakable, that no enemy shall ever triumph over Israel.
Okay, now we put the glasses back down.
Okay, scripture tells us that in the land of Canaan, at the time of a famine, our patriarch Jacob sent his sons to Egypt to allow their flocks to graze, for the pasture lands in Canaan were barren. It was not their intention to settle in Egypt, merely to visit and find relief from want. There were but 70 people who arrived in Egypt, but in time their number increased. Soon they grew also in strength and became a mighty people. The Egyptians came to fear them, for they reasoned, in time of war, they might join with enemy nations and become a threatening force. They, therefore, decided to subdue them with forced labor, and to reduce their numbers by casting male children into the river. Taskmasters were placed over the Hebrews, who whipped and tortured them, compelling them to make bricks and build great cities for Pharaoh. The task was inhuman and too great to bear. The Jewish people cried out to God, and he heard their cry. He called to Moses, charging him to appear before Pharaoh and to demand that the people be released. Pharaoh was obstinate and would not heed the word of God. It was then that Moses foretold the punishment which the Almighty would bring upon Pharaoh and the Egyptians. Plagues would be visited upon the land of Egypt, in which many would perish. Pharaoh defied God and placed his trust in his own powers. In the face of all pleas, he refused to free the Jewish people. In consequence, the plagues descended upon Egypt. Many perished, and the suffering was great. Pharaoh, nonetheless, remained obstinate. He would not yield. When the 10th plague was visited upon them, the death of firstborn sons of Egyptians, a great cry went up throughout Egypt, and Pharaoh finally ordered Moses to take his people out of the land.
The 10 plagues. When men defy the will of God, they bring pain and suffering upon themselves. God's law aims for the welfare of happiness of all mankind. To deny his law and to do evil brings destruction upon those who perpetrate it.
When Pharaoh defied the command of God to release the Jewish people, he invited adversity upon himself and his own people. Though the plagues that were visited upon the Egyptians were the result of their own evil, we do not rejoice over their downfall and defeat.
Judaism regards all men as children of God, even enemies who seek to destroy our people.
When, for the sake of our welfare, they met with suffering and death, we mourn their loss and express sorrow over their destruction.
A full cup and the symbol of complete joy, though we celebrate the triumph of our sacred cause, our happiness is not complete so long as others had to be sacrificed for its sake. We shall therefore diminish the wine in our cups as we recall the plagues visited upon the Egyptians to give expression to our sorrow over the losses which each plague exacted. We now recite the list of 10 plagues, pouring off wine as each is mentioned.
Okay, now you have the little plate here. So we're going to read the 10 plagues, and each time you pour a little bit of
just the teeny weeny bit wine on the plate.
Okay. Dam.
Mommy, you don't do it.
You know what, Mommy? Yeah, you can do it.
You do it with your finger like this.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Dam. Blood.
Dam. It's Fardea.
Frogs.
Kenim.
Lice.
Arof.
Nets.
Deber.
Moraine.
Shachin.
Boils.
Barat.
Hail.
Arbe.
Locusts.
Choshech.
Darkness.
Makat Bechorot.
The slain of the firstborn.
Okay. Okay. Dayenu.
Okay. Great and numerous are the kindnesses which the Lord extended to our fathers. For each of them, we offer thanks and humble gratitude. Okay, this we're going to sing a little bit in Hebrew.
What?
Okay, let's sing this in Hebrew. Kama malot tovot l'makom aleinu Ilu hotzianu Hotzianu mi-mitzrayim Hotzianu mi-mitzrayim Ve-lo asanu Ve-nshmatim Dayenu 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 Dai, 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 dai Okay, here we're just think about all the wondrous things that happened. Dayeno means it would have been sufficient, it would have been enough. So if he had only redeemed us from Egypt, but he had not judged our oppressors, would have been enough. If he had only done that, but he had not divided the Red Sea, it would have been enough. If he'd only divided the Red Sea, but not protected us in the wilderness, Dayeno. If he protected us in the wilderness, but had not sent us the man, the manna from heaven, would have been enough. If he had not given us the manna, but he, if he had only given us the manna from heaven, but not given us water to sustain us, it would have been enough. If he had only given us water, but had not given us the Sabbath, it would have been enough. If he had not, if only given us the Sabbath, but had not given us the Torah, the crown of our life, it would have been enough. If he'd only given us the Torah, but had not given us the Holy Temple, it would have been enough. How great and numerous are the kindnesses which the Lord has shown us. For each act of goodness, we are abundantly grateful.
Okay, now, the three symbols of Passover?
Yeah.
Okay.
Rabbi Gamliel.
Rabbi Gamliel thought, whosoever does not mention the three symbols of Passover has not fulfilled his duty. They are Pesach, or Paschal lamb, Matzos, and Maror.
Okay, so again we have the...
Okay.
What is the significance of the Pesach, the Paschal lamb, symbolized by the shank bone, which our ancestors ate in the days when the temple was in existence? It served as a reminder that the Lord Pesach passed over the homes of our fathers when he killed the firstborn sons of the Egyptians. The matzah, can you pick it up?
The whole matzah?
Yeah. What is the significance of this matzah? It is the flat, unleavened bread which our fathers ate during their departure from Egypt, for in their haste they could not wait for the dough to rise. What is the significance of these bitter herbs? They serve to remind us that the Egyptians embittered the lives of our ancestors, as the Torah relates, and they made their lives bitter with hard service in mortar and in brick, and in all manner of service in the field, in all their service, wherein they made them serve with rigor.
Okay. Okay. You're gonna let her. I'll let you read it.
ועבור זה עשה אדוני לי בצאתי ממצרים, לא את אבותינו בלבד גאל הקדוש ברוך הוא, אלא אף אותנו גאל עמהם, שנאמר ואותנו הוציא משם למען יביא אותנו לתת לנו את הארץ אשר נשבע לאבותינו.
Okay.
So here you can read it in English, in every generation.
Ah. And every that's across the other apartment. And every generation, each Jew must look upon himself as though he personally was among those who went forth from Egypt. Not our fathers alone did the holy 1. Blessed by he redeemed from suffering, but also us and our families. The struggle of freedom is a continuous struggle, for never does man reach total liberty and opportunity.
In every age, some new freedom is won and established, adding to the advancement of human happiness and security.
Yet each age uncovers a formerly unrecognized servitude, requiring new liberation to set man's soul free.
In every age, the concept of freedom grows broader, widening the horizons for finer and nobler living.
Each generation is duty-bound to contribute to this growth. Else mankind ideals become stagnant and stationary.
The events in Egypt were but the beginning of a force in history which will forever continue.
In this spirit, we see ourselves as participants in the Exodus, for we must dedicate our energies to the cause there begun.
In our day, we shall defend the heritage of liberty taught by the Torah and preserved by democracies.
Okay.
As inheritors of the priceless heritage of liberty, we join now in praising and glorifying God's holy name for the miracles which he wrought in the past and also in our day. We offer him our thankfulness. He did deliver us from slavery to freedom, from sorrow to happiness, from mourning to rejoicing, from darkness to light. In gratitude for these manifold blessings, we shall sing songs of praise to him.
Okay, now we've got to refill the glass.
Okay, I, at this point, add grape juice.
I'll add yours a little bit. Okay. Yeah. Gotta refill the glasses.
Because we poured out before when we said the plagues. So.
Okay. It's a little bit left. It's okay.
Now. Okay, this part, if you'll excuse me, I do in Hebrew. And we are at a little. Okay.
A little.
One second.
14.
Okay. I'm going to do the halal in Hebrew.
Okay. Let's try to find it.
Hallelujah, 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 Adonai. Hallelujah, 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 Shem Adonai. Yehi Shem Adonai Meroach, Yata ve'Adolam. Mimizron Shem Eshavevo'o, Lula Shem Adonai. Hamakoko Yim Adonai. Adashamayim kvodo, v'kadonai Eloheinu, Adwabihil ashab, amashbili lirok, adbashamayim uvarets, mekimim me'afrata, meshpon yerim ethyon, lehoshivim ne'nivim, im ne'nivei amo, moshivim. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Malachayam,
Kitanus,
Italanos.
Ayaden.
Ayaden.
Tiso leajo.
Tiso bajo.
Eharim.
Eharim.
El que duje elim.
El que duje elim.
Yevaot.
Yevaot.
מלפני אדם,
מלפני אדם,
חולי הארץ,
חולי הארץ,
מלפני,
מלפני,
אלוהי יעקב,
אלוהי יעקב,
אהובי יצור,
אמרו יעשו,
אגמיים,
אגמיים,
חלמיש,
החלמיש,
למים ומים,
למים ומים.
ברוך אתה אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר גאלנו וגאל את אבותינו ממצרים, והגיענו ללילה הזה לאכול בו מצה מרור. כן, אדוני אלוהינו ואלוהי אבותינו, יביאנו למועדים, לרגלים אחרים הבאים לקראתנו לשלום, שמחים בבניין עירך, בסיסים בעבודתך, ונאכל שם מן הזבחים ומן הפסחים אשר יגיע דמם על קיר מזבחך לרצון, ונודה לך שיר חדש על גאולתנו ועל גדות נפשנו. ברוך אתה אדוני גאל ישראל.
Where are you?
Okay, now we'll go back to English.
What page are you in?
I was reading in the Hebrew, but now we are
yes.
At end of page 15.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Borei Pri Hagafen. Now you drink the wine.
Okay, now we do
Rachatz again.
Now, again, we wash our hands, only this time we say it with a blessing for washing the hands. Mm-hmm. So,
I will do it again.
You'll do it again. Well, like I said, it's usually the children do it, mm-hmm. And since you're the youngest one here.
Do it again?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Hey, Jacqueline, you're the youngest one, that's
No, it's okay.
Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kishanu Mitzvotav Vetzivanu Al Netilat Yadayim.
So, who next?
I know
the blessing. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kishanu Mitzvotav Vetzivanu Al Netilat Yadayim. Thank you, Mami. I'll say it to my mother. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Kishanu Bemitzvotav Vetzivanu Al Netilat Yadayim.
Now you just say
Amen. Amen. And now we have to, I'll do it for you. And I'll say the blessing for you too. Baruch Ata Adonai, Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Kishanu Bemitzvotav Vetzivanu Al Netilat Yadayim. Amen.
Okay. So this says, Blessed art thou, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who has sanctified us by thy commandments and has commanded us concerning the washing of the hands. Okay, before, you can just stay here for now. Because before you eat, you're supposed to wash your hands. So up until now, we've only had the symbolic food, but now we're going to eat the matzah, and which is like the beginning of the real eating, which is why we had to do the symbolic washing of the hands. And the middle matzah.
Huh?
And what's left of the middle matzah?
The middle matzah, I broke the top.
Yeah, no, you're supposed to do both.
Ah, well, you have a lot.
Well, we need matzah, so.
Ah, okay, yeah. Okay, you just take this.
Yeah, I
take this. Mommy, it'll be okay. You eat as much as you want. Now, okay. We have to do the blessing.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kishanu mitzvotav vetzivanu al achilat matzah. Okay. What's the next?
Maror.
One sec. Ah, Maror.
Okay. Now, you take,
well, everyone
takes, you take a piece of this, and a piece of the Maror. You take a piece of this, the Chavoset, and a piece of the, yeah, okay. Because remember before, it said that we sweeten the bitterness with the sweetness. So this is sweet, and this is horseradish. Mm-hmm. Hot. So this is to remind us of the bitterness, and this is to resemble like the bricks of the slaves when they were in Egypt. So we eat it together.
Okay.
Baruch
ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu al achilat maror. If you cannot eat that's very harif, because that's horseradish that makes you whoo. Okay, next.
Korech. Now you take the baro matzah. In ancient times, the revered sage Hillel observed literally the biblical commandment concerning the eating of the Pesach with matzah and maror. It is stated, with matzah and maror shall they eat it. Thus did he combine them even as we now do, and ate them together. Okay, so we take another piece of the maror, the bitter herbs. And this time we eat it. The matzah sandwich.
That's not for you, mommy. That's like too spicy.
Okay, we take another piece of the bitter herbs.
Make yourself like a little sandwich with it. And it's too harif for you, mommy.
Yeah.
And we eat it. You're laughing, you should see your face.
Well, I didn't even eat it yet. Well.
Okay, so we made it through the first half.
Yeah.
You want to take a break with your video, or? Because we're just going to eat now.
I don't know, it's finished.
No, we're eating, and afterwards we continue the second half of the
program.
I'm just
yeah.
Honey,
because
the plates need to be cleaned up.
I know.